With powerhouse Kansas coming to town Monday night, it would have been pretty easy to overlook ninth place Texas Tech. But considering the Clones lost to the Red Raiders last month, that simply was not going to happen. Clones more than ready to avenge that slip up in Lubbock. Will Clyburn buries one from the corner early on, kind of the theme from today. Will had 17 points. Cyclones grabbed the 2-point lead. Great day for Melvin Ejim, hitting one from outside as well. Cyclones starting to roll. Tyrus McGee, the super sub off the bench, he hits one from the corner. You know, Melvin Ejim can hit from the outside. He can also run the one-man fast break. Ejim all alone, and he knows what to do. Ejim throws down the two-hand jam. He had 13 points and 13 boards, his 12th double-double this season. Chris Babb, also a great day. Babb noticed a defensive stopper coming into his own on offense recently. 5 threes today. Cyclones just a 7-point lead at the half, but really broke it open from downtown. 11 threes in the game, second half. Break out your umbrellas. It is raining threes. Babb had 17. Cyclones roll 86-66. 22 straight wins at Hilton. Tony Seaman says this was a fun one.
Iowa State gets another commanding win at home. It's their 22nd straight here at Hilton Coliseum, and yet again, they did it by spreading the wealth around. 4 players hit double digits in scoring this afternoon, and the team says, that's just Cyclone basketball.
We started playing our type of basketball. You know, we started rebounding the ball, started pushing it, getting passes in transition, getting 3 balls, getting shots up. We just started playing our type of basketball and having fun out there, and I think that really worked in our advantage. We were able to speed up the tempo, and we really took advantage of it.
I just think it was our energy, especially in the second half. First half, we kind of got lulled to sleep with their game like we did down there. And, we were able to get out of it, the last couple minutes of the first half. And then second half, we came out with a lot of energy.
I thought our ball movement was excellent that second half. We get 18 assists on 26 baskets. That's a sign that you played a very unselfish game and had the ball moving around. And that was a difference from the time when we played down there. We really got stagnant, the most stagnant we've been all season. And to go out there and play the right way, continue to get that ball moving around the perimeter, I thought was the difference.
And the Cyclones are hoping to keep on playing their style of basketball moving forward. It's a quick turnaround for ISU. They're right back at it on Monday night at home when Kansas comes to town. In Ames, Tony Seaman, KCCI, Iowa's sports leader.